Good evening, everybody. I'm Mike Dardis.
And good evening to you. I'm Cherie Palello. Tonight, one man is dead, murdered, and dismembered.
Now, according to police, three men have confessed. And as odd as this crime was, the reason the men gave for doing it is just as disturbing. News 5's Amy Wagner joining us live with the breaking details. Amy?
Well, Mike, detectives from the Boone County Sheriff's Department spent most of the day sifting through tons and tons of trash out here at this landfill, searching for dismembered body parts. And as bizarre as this murder case is, investigators say the motive for the murder is absolutely shocking.
30-some-odd years in this business.
And investigators from the Boone County Sheriff's Department admit they've never seen anything quite like the brutal murder case they're working on right now. Today, a dozen detectives sifted through trash in the Rumkey landfill in Pendleton County, searching for the dismembered body parts of a victim. Three Boone County men confessed to killing Wednesday night.
So three men, under the ruse of a drug deal with this individual, met with him, kidnapped him, beat him, killed him, and then dismembered him.
Those men, 21-year-old Jeffrey Allen, 23-year-old Anthony Baumgartner, and 22-year-old Stephen Hartness, are now charged with murder, kidnapping, abuse of a corpse, and tampering with evidence. They led investigators to a field in Verona last night, near where Allen lives, where detectives say they made a gruesome discovery.
Because all we found so far is a torso and a couple leg pieces. I hate to be that graphic, but that's exactly what it is.
But the suspects also admitted to detectives that after dismembering the victim in that field, they later dumped parts of his body in the dumpster of a motel on Dream Street in Florence. And detectives say the most baffling thing about this crime is the reason the three men say they killed their victim, a suspected heroin dealer.
This guy was an evil, and they were going to take care of him.
Now, investigators say what's also surprising to them is only two of these guys have a prior criminal history in Boone County, and they're only minor charges, a disorderly conduct and a criminal trespassing charge. Meanwhile, as for that victim, we expect to learn much more about him tomorrow. Reporting live in Pendleton County tonight, I'm Amy Wagner, News 5.